Hello everyone, I'm Claudio Messale, I'm the Exterior Governance Chief Designer from Ford of Europe, and I would like to talk to you today about the new Mustang Mach-E, a great car that we just introduced, and I would like to talk to you a little bit about the history and where we came from. When we started this journey about 3 years ago, we had basically a complete global team working on this project, because it was a really important project for Ford Motor Company. It's the first mass-produced electric vehicle. So we had a complete new platform for that. And we wanted to give a strong personality, something that is recognizable, which can really appeal to this type of customers. So as you can see in the early sketches, we were trying to sketch on top of some of the DNA cues which are typical of the Mustang. But Mustang is a coupe, and the proportion of this new electric vehicle is more of a crossover, is more of an SUV. You can see on this animation how a normal Mustang gets transformed into the Mustang Mach-E. It shows very well that the proportions grows a little bit because we do want to have the space inside, but the character and the main element of the Mustang is kind of reproduced on this larger package. Even from far away, the car is still recognizable as a Ford Mustang. While you're approaching the car, you will see the beautifully sculpted and crafted for aerodynamics shapes, the beautiful details, attention for details, and the beautifully sculpted surfaces. The stance and the proportion are key to provide the Mustangness on the vehicle. The stance of the vehicle is helped by the bigger tire and wheels, and also by the length of the beautifully sculpted hood. The length that we achieved by moving the A-pillar rearward, and to avoid that we lose too much space inside, we actually have a very round windshield with it. The body side is characterized by the very sporty silhouette, coupe-like. And to avoid that we lose space on the inside, we actually got this black section here hanging on the spoiler on the rear, which disguises the height in the area of the rear passenger. So they actually, there is a plenty of room for the rear passengers. Going back on the rear of the vehicle, you can recognize the truncated rear end, typical of a Mustang, and the 3-bar light, very recognizable, even though it's done in a more modern graphic. Let's talk now about the interior. This was actually a dream come true for the interior design team. Complete new platform opens up a lot of potential. So what we decided is to really understand the user, how do they actually want their interior to look like and how do they use it. So we asked a lot of customers to come into the design center. We did show some elements which are low fidelity, stereoform, something that helped the customer to actually pick things, move them around until they were, you know, comfortable with it. And they decided that they wanted a very light, airy interior. You can see it's quite spaceful. And you can see in the upper region of the dashboard, you have this double cowl element, which is borrowed again from Mustang Qs. But apart from that, all the rest is really modern. You can see that in front of the driver, there is a 10.2-inch screen, which has all the important information. The major element is this 15.5-inch screen, centrally positioned. Most of the functions are inside the screen, so there is not that many buttons any longer, apart from the volume, which we felt it was important to maintain. It's really nice, and also the customer really liked the idea of maintaining the rotary volume button in there. Of course, this works like a normal smartphone or a pad that you can pinch, you can swipe with the touch. Overall, I think the car has a very muscular stance, but it's not the typical of a bodybuilder, but something more like of an athlete, like a runner, for example. We also wanted to take some of the naming which was quite successful in the 60s, like Mach. Mach is the speed of sound, and it was perfect for this car because it represents power, it represents speed, and the strong torque which this car will be delivered to its drivers. Overall, I feel very proud of the Mustang Mach-E. It's a great car, and we all feel that it's going to do very well in the European market. Based on the success of the order that we received so far, I think it's going to be a stunning success.